Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. In this video, I am going to narrate the fate which Damyanti had to face in a dense jungle where her husband, the king Nal, had left her. Half-clad in a short sheet of cloth, a woman who, according to the author of Mahabharata, had solid hips, lovely breasts, a face shining like full moon, looking so innocent, eyebrows slanting, and a voice which was music to the ears. She was attacked by a hunter who wanted to molest her, but she cursed him, and that curse killed the man. Thereafter, Damyanti started wandering in the forest in search of her husband, who had deserted her with the intention that she might that way go to her parents' house in the kingdom of Vidarbha, where her father was the king. A forest is never a very happy place unless one is going to a resort. All sorts of animals roam in a forest. Sometimes there are fires. Damyanti, you can imagine her condition. She is dressed in half a sheet of cloth, so most of her body is naked. She might not have had a bath for days together. She was hungry. She was a wanderer who did not know what to do, and she was looking for her husband who had deserted her. This particular narration is soaked in Viraha Ras, the Ras of separation, pining, a very important emotion in anyone's life. The forest was crowded by tigers, leopards, deer, buffaloes, boars, and hundreds of varieties of birds. There were trees all around, trees which were touching, kissing the sky, shal, bamboos, people, palash, arjun, semul, jamun, mangoes, kadamb, amla, berries. Dates, date palms. Damyanti looked at all this. She was not interested. She was trying to find her husband. She looked at the peaks of the mountains in the background, peaks which were colorful because of the minerals contained therein. She listened to the music of the birds. She looked at caves, peeped into them, dared to go into them, but Nal was nowhere to be found. She came across rivulets falls, ponds. Nal was nowhere there. The rivers flowing through the forests held her attention. She thought he might be swimming somewhere. He was known to be a great swimmer. No, he was not to be found. She looked at alligators in the river. She looked at huge, mighty serpents on the ground, blessed with a glow coming from a very respectable family. This daughter of Vidarbha, with great patience, wandered alone looking for her husband. Every part of her body, every limb was soaked in her devotion to her man. She sat under a stone, under the ledge, protruding out, and lamented, "My husband, the king of Nishadha, who had a large, brave chest, where have you gone deserting me in this lonely forest? You had performed Ashwamedh Yagya. It does not behove you to have treated me like this. This is pure falsehood. This is papa. You have deserted me, my husband. I have done no wrong to you. You had sent me messages through swans, praising my beauty. Have you forgotten them? O lion among men, all the learning in the Vedas is inferior to one word of truth spoken by a human being. You should be true to your words, your promises. Why have you deserted me? I am your Damyanti. I am being destroyed in this terrible, frightening forest. You don't reply me. Where are you? My lament does not reach you, my husband. You are being very cruel. Look, there is a frightening tiger standing in front of me. It wants to eat me up, cut my limbs to pieces, bleed me to death. And where are you? You should be here to protect me. As a husband, that is your duty. My beloved husband, you used to tell me, there is no woman on the earth dearer to you than me. Prove this statement. Come, rescue me from this forest. Why have you left me naked to suffer? Even the birds have eyes, they are looking at my body. I am humble, I am humiliated, I am weak, I have lost my glow. I find it difficult even to cover my breasts, my hips, my legs, my feet. I feel like a doe separated from her herd. I'm weeping, sitting alone, wandering, hungry, thirsty. You are a cruel man. Why so? What have I done to you? Where are you sleeping, my husband? In a forest like this, where tigers roam, elephants wander. Whom should I ask? Where have you gone? There is nobody here, no human being. I'm going to die like this. Do you want me to die like this? What do I see here? A lion walking towards me. Its teeth are bare. It's hankering for my flesh. Now I'm going to him to be eaten. That way at least I'll punish you for your desertion. She addresses the lion. I am the daughter of Vidarbha king. I am Damyanti. I am the wife of the king of Nishadha, Nala. I am looking for my husband in this forest. Please help me. Give me some good news about my husband. If you can't eat me up, I don't mind. What would I do by living? But no. The lion is not willing to assuage my fears. The lion is not willing to give me any information. He is moving towards a stream which has sweet water so that he can drink it. Okay, let me ask the mountain. Oh, holy mountain, I can see your tops covered by minerals. Multicolored, multifaceted, majestic. It seems that you are like a flag hoisted above this jungle. Mark this simile, mark this image. The mountain is like a flag hoisted above a jungle. This jungle, which is full of tigers, lions, boars, elephants, bears, deer, and hundreds of birds, palash, trees, ashok, bakul, punnag, kaner, mangoes. There are several streams in this forest. So, O mighty mountain, tell me about my husband. Do you have any information about him? You give shelter to everybody who comes here. They can stay here with you. But where should I go? I bow to you. I am the daughter of a king. I am the wife of a king. I am known as Damyanti. My husband is a very handsome man. He is mighty, of the mightiest. He has performed Ashwamedh Yagya. He worships Brahmins. He is a man of good character. He speaks the truth. He does not look for any defects in anybody else. He is a brave man. He is rich. He is religious and he is pure. Tell me about him. He has conquered all the enemies. And so has my father, the king of Vidarbha. My husband Nal is as charming as Krishna. He is called Punyashlok, that is holy, like the scriptures. He is of a very charitable temperament. Help me to find out about his whereabouts. When would I hear his voice, which roars like a drum, but which is sweet? Damyanti was wandering like a mad woman, writes the author of Mahabharata. Her eyebrows were slanted, beautiful, dark. She had long hair going up to her hips. Her hips were protruding outwards. Her breasts were protruding in the front. Her teeth was neat and clean and white, and her face was charming. Her eyes were large. She looked glorious, even into a torn out sheet of cloth. Such was the state in which Damyanti moved in the forest, looking for Nala, who had deserted her. The type of search which the poet has written about is to be also found in Abhijnana Shakuntalam, written much later by Kalidas. There it is Dushyant who is wandering in search of Shakuntala, and on the other hand, Shakuntala wanders in search of Dushyant. All this is poetry of the highest order, of Viraha Ras, full of emotion. Listen to it again and again and enjoy. Damyanti faces an Ashoka tree at one point of time. There are birds chirping from its branches. She wept. Her eyes were full of tears. She addressed Ashoka, saying, "Look, your name is that of an entity without sorrow. Would you not remove my sorrow? Would you not prove your name to be truthful?" No replies came to Damyanti from the tree. She suffered and suffered.